We have an hour-long debate starting right now between the two candidates who want to be New Mexico's next governor. Welcome both Republican Susana Martinez and Democrat Diane Denish. Here are the rules for tonight's debate. We will start with opening statements, which will each have 90 seconds for those opening statements. Now, panel members will have 30 seconds to ask their questions, and each candidate will have 90 seconds to respond. Then there will be an additional 30 seconds of rebuttal for each candidate as well. And the candidates will also have 60 seconds for opening statements. The League of Women Voters of Central New Mexico will serve as tonight's timekeepers. Now, joining us tonight on our panel, who will question the debates, from the Albuquerque Journal, our partners in this debate, politics writer Sean Olson. Also on the panel, my co-anchor with Action 7 News, Shelley Rabando, and Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendes. Thank you all for joining us tonight. Now let's begin with Diane Denish with your opening statement, which again, 90 seconds.
Good evening, and thank you for hosting this debate. 16 days, New Mexicans. Over the next 16 days, at early vote and on Election Day, you'll decide how the state's going to go forward for the next few years. Like so many of you, I'm not happy with the way things are. Things need to be better, and that's why I'm running for governor. I won't stop fighting until they are better. I won't stop fighting until every New Mexico family gets a fair shake. And that's what this election is about. It's not about those nasty negative ads and all that noise. It's about you and who's going to help you and your family get ahead. And on that point, the choice is very clear. I've been fighting for New Mexico families all of my life, first as a young single mother and a small business owner, and then as lieutenant governor, fighting for every New Mexico families. My opponent, she has a different agenda. I want you to listen very carefully tonight, and what you'll hear is somebody who will come down on the side of the special interest every single time. That's not the change that we need in New Mexico. As governor, I'll put New Mexico families first every single day. I'll take on predatory lenders, the big insurance companies, and anybody else that wants to take advantage of our families. I know as governor that New Mexico needs a governor who's on their side, because times are tough. Times are tough. They want a governor who's on their side. I hope to earn your vote.
And 90 seconds now for Susana Martinez to make her opening statement.
Good evening, and thank you for the opportunity to visit with you in your homes. You know, growing up, my family lived paycheck to paycheck. My father was a deputy sheriff, and my mother worked in an office. And in high school, one day, my parents decided they wanted to build a business. I was terrified. I knew how much money we didn't really have in the bank. However, together, they started a business, and I was their first security guard. I was a security guard at a bingo and started with them in their business. They grew that business to over 125 employees in three states. They understood how they needed to work hard, keep more of their own money so they could invest in their business and develop a new job, grow a new job, get a new contract. Then I went on to law school, and I had a decision to make as a lawyer, what kind of a lawyer I wanted to be. And it wasn't about money. What I wanted to do was fight for kids and families in my community. And in Las Cruces, I did just that. I have dedicated the last 24 years to specializing in prosecuting people who abuse kids sexually and physically and kill our children. And I want to fight as governor for all New Mexico children to make sure they get educated and they receive a world-class education, that they have a job to go to once they come to New Mexico, once they live here and bring their children here, once they develop their families here and create jobs. We've lost too much in the last 8 years. We can't afford to continue on that same route.
Time now for our question and answer period of tonight's debate. Our first panel question comes from the Journal's Sean Olson. Sean?
Both of you have promised you will not raise taxes, cut education, or Medicaid. That leaves only about 40% of the state budget that can be cut. What specific cuts do you plan to implement for the next fiscal year to resolve what will be at least a $230 million budget shortfall?
We're in a global economic crisis. Everybody's hurting. Our families are hurting. New Mexico's hurting. States around us are hurting. I put out a plan a few weeks ago, a 36-point plan. I'm not going to go over every one of those 36 points, but here's what we have to do in state government to tighten our belt. First, we have to get rid of the political appointees, high-paid political appointees. Do smart reorganization, consolidate services. Third, use technology in a smarter way. Use New Mexico's resources efficiently. Institute a wellness plan to make sure that we have keep our health premiums level for state employees, and redo how we do capital outlay. Cut the state cart fleet. I've been Lieutenant Governor, and I've been proud of the way that I've managed my budget. Every year, I've come in under budget. Every year, I've come in under budget, and I've returned $300,000 to the New Mexico General Fund. So while we're talking budgets, my opponent, did you find out how she ran her budget? She's not only grown her budget by 70%, while the in the time she's been in office, 160%. And here's how she spent it. At the end, instead of turning money back to the general fund when she had money, she said, we have to hurry up and spend it. She bought luxury cars. She took her staff to a fancy resort. That's a difference in how we manage our budgets.
All right, Ms. Martinez, your answer?
There clearly is a difference in how we manage our budgets, because as crime grew in Doña Ana County, we had to respond, and we had to prosecute those cases, and we had to be tough on those cases. We live on the border. However, state government was on a spending spree. $5.5 million for a jet, $360,000 spent flying around to a parade with family members, and 38 times against regulations. What's important here is the spending spree that this administration went on. When Governor Johnson left office, there was $360 million in reserves. And instead, this administration, and you're part of this administration, to deny that you're any part of this administration is really trying to kid the people who are watching this. You are part of this administration, and you went on a spending spree, and you spent those $360 million, and then you turned around and you spent more than we had in the budget today. We're asking families to cut back their budgets at home, and instead, this administration has gone on spending for jets, spending for trips flying around on an airplane, and that is simply not acceptable to the families at home. You cannot expect for them to think that you weren't part of growing exempt positions from the 180 that existed to nearly 600 today.
You have a 30
seconds. Susana, that's almost laughable coming from you. It's laughable. 160% your budget grew, 70%. Every year I came in under budget, and I returned money to the state budget. $300,000 I returned to the state budget. She had a policy. If you don't have anything to do with it, spend it in a hurry, on luxury vehicles, on taking your staff to fancy retreats. I had a policy. Let's return that money to the state coffers and use it for priorities for New Mexico families.
30-second rebuttal.
That's how out of touch I think you are, Diane, in reference to what's going on in the border. We have had murder in some years as high as 130% increase. We have crimes that have increased, quadrupled in DWIs, drug trafficking, human trafficking, burglary. When the economy went down and your administration made it worse in New Mexico, crime goes up. We had to respond to that. And when we need a vehicle to travel to bring a victim from Hatch or Sunland Park to the courthouse, then that's important that we have the vehicle to bring their family, put in a car seat. Make sure that we have them as part of the process. You could call it a luxury vehicle all you want. What's important here is that we brought justice to people in New Mexico, in Doña Ana County,
and we spent that money wisely. You went way over your 30 seconds.